those are the teams that they're rooting for. They want to see those top two teams soak up as many points as possible so they can keep that third place, but they want to get it working here. Blind pick on the Grand Arena will change my mind, be able to start to solidify their spot to the tournament.
Not surprising to see Method Black lead the blind pick with this Demon Hunter, Unholy Death Knight, Restoration Druid composition. We've only seen really two compositions in the game even give it some struggle, let alone take wins against it, and Change My Mind do not have those as options, that being the Windwalker Death Knight Mistweaver and the Arms Warrior Death Knight Mistweaver. Change My Mind are limited. This Rogue Mage Druid is basically their bread and butter, and they have Valet as a pocket Shadow Priest, but even that composition I don't believe is powerful enough, so Change My Mind will be battling upstream to take down Method Black here in this series. We did see some hotfixes to Unholy Death Knight, so perhaps Npoike will take advantage of that, be able to regenerate his mana for a kill later on into the match. But aside from that, it's going to be a tough one, Ben.
Definitely going to be a struggle here for Change My Mind. This is the composition they have struggled with so much. Looks like a nice little setup here onto Raikou into a kidney shot. Will he go down? One Maledict does connect from Npoike. Good, potentially good setup here onto Raikou with a full polymorph onto Chaz. Raikou, what is he going to do? Netherwalk is activated. Still has a lot of defensive cooldowns at his disposal. And Chaz actually got a nice Iron Bark as well, potentially keeping him alive. But the crowd control has not ended. Acro commits the Vanish. Gets the Garrote Silence onto Chaz. And a kidney shot. Raikou still keeping himself alive. Good denial there by Method Black.
Yeah, Acro making a swap to try and bait Chaz into bark skinning. Basically, Change My Mind have held Vendetta in their back pocket to try and get a kill. They got the Glider's Medallion from Chaz. They got the Netherwalk from Raikou. They were trying to make Chaz panic, but you're really not going to crack Method Black that easily. Change My Mind, I believe, are ahead on mana, so they still have something at least going for them. And that Vendetta now is becoming a liability the longer that Acro waits to use it. Unfortunately, being crowd controlled for some time with these Chains of Ice, Shadow stepping into the fight, engaging with cheap shots, so this isn't going to allow Raikou to be held down very long, and he can escape to safety with those fell rushes. Now with that I-beam, good kidney shot on the I-beam, denying some extra damage. Swapsy's going to respect this trade, and we often see this from Method Black, that they will use the Unholy Death Knight's anti-magic zone and honor talent to trade with an Assassination Rogue's Vendetta, and this is typically the trade that we see from Swapsy against this class every single time. Definitely Change My Mind are going to need to look to crowd control Swapsy when they go for these Vendetta attempts. Currently, we see good crowd control initiated by the side of Change My Mind. Chaz opting to respect this engagement using his Glider's Medallion. Still an expected trade from the side of Method Black, and not many openings forming themselves up just yet.
Yeah, Raikou hasn't been able to land too many mana rifts. Swapsy sets him up nicely. Now Npoike could be in some trouble. Two Gladiator's Maledicts do connect from Method Black. Npoike is still in a little trouble, but committing the Barkskin and Iron Bark should be okay as he sneaks by on the pillar. There's a beautiful Frost over there by Fried Kitty, keeping both Swapsy and Raikou locked down as Acro makes his way over to Chaz, trying to pressure him a little bit. If you look at mana, so far, I believe Method Black still has quite a massive lead. And Poike once again into a stun. Raikou now finally able to land some mana rest, but Chaz hasn't been able to drink. The one thing Change My Mind has been doing a great job in this matchup so far is making sure Chaz is at least trying to throw some heals out onto Raikou and Swapsy, and been denying any time he goes for those drink setups.
We do see a setup here onto Raikou, but with no crowd control onto Chaz, easily healing through that frozen orb assault of Fried Kitty, and I'm basically running my head through the options for Change My Mind. What exactly can they do to actually win? And one option would be to survive until 50% dampening and have your Restoration Druid maintain his mana and kill the Death Knight with pressure. I see that as an option. That's probably the most difficult one to actually do because you're facing Mana Rift on the Demon Hunter, which is consistently draining your Druid's mana. So it's unlikely, but it would be impressive if Change My Mind can make it to that win condition. Another win condition for them would obviously be to get Raikou's Glider's Medallion, as they have in this position now with 1:54 remaining. Bait Raikou into a bad position. Kidney shot, smoke bomb, and try to kill Raikou 100-0. We have seen Rogue Mage Druid employ that. I think that's the closest to a kill we've ever seen a Rogue Mage Druid get when facing this composition, but before deep dampening, it's the most likely. And then their other win condition is Chaz chokes and just dies to pressure, which I think is also incredibly unlikely. So Change My Mind, right now their only option is to go after Raikou in a smoke bomb, currently having committed their vendetta to Chaz. It seems like they're trying to go for the third win condition, which would be Chaz choking. Let's see how he handles it.
So you brought up waiting for that deep dampening mark to actually be able to take down Swapsy. Is there a certain critical mass, really, where you do say, okay, all of a sudden death strikes, this self-healing that we do see them have, just falls off, and you hit that certain mark, and then you can push in, and that's when the Death Knight becomes the real kill target.
Well, this is the smoke bomb attempt under Raikou. This is the situation I thought would be most likely for Change My Mind to get a kill before dampening, and so far in this exchange, they've only gotten Blur, but they're continuing the crowd control quite effectively. Minpuke chained that smoke bomb into a cyclone, and then Fried Kitty followed up with polymorphs. Unfortunately, not going to be enough for Change My Mind to put Raikou down. And now both Acro and Fried Kitty on the back foot. But as far as what is the magic marker for dampening, from my expectation and from what I've observed, it's around 40 to 50%. That's the critical mass for these Unholy Death Knights to be overwhelmed by most teams, especially teams with the Mortal Wounds effect, which the Assassination Rogue brings. I'm curious what build of Frostmage Fried Kitty is running, if he's going for an Ice Lance build for more instant cast. I think he needs to be if they want to find a kill onto the Death Knight. If he's running Frostbolt build, then he's just simply never going to get a cast off, never be able to pressure down. So far, I like what Change My Mind have been trying to do. It's at least kept them in the fight against this composition, frequently switching between Chaz and Raikou. This is definitely the best strategy before dampening if they're looking to run Chaz out of mana, as since the recent nerfs to Focus Growth make Life Bloom so expensive. So Change My Mind, I would say, are playing this matchup quite effectively, but it's still just such an uphill battle that they're still going to need a miracle. They've at least managed to make it to 10% dampening. 30% more, Minpoike. Can you keep your mana above zero for 30% more dampening? That's the test.
Fried Kitty getting a little bit low. Could be forced into the ice block. It was a scary moment. He was interrupted there on Frost. And you kind of mentioned Fried Kitty's build. He's still going for a lot of the Frostbolt talents and Azerite traits. So really relying on getting consistent Frostbolts off. But that's one of the difficult things when you have an Holy Death Knight as well as a Demon Hunter on you. Your damage really does get limited in that regard. So maybe an error there by Fried Kitty, but I think what it comes down to is he wants to be able to punish them. If they're not on Fried Kitty, at least he'll be able to tee off on them, get lots of pressure for his team, and honestly, he's been doing a good job kiting in this matchup. Mana being even is pretty remarkable at this point. Fried Kitty having to be forced into his first ice block. Swapsy and Raikou having a little bit too much uptime there as Acro is trying to pressure down Chaz, manages to get his trinket with the blind. That's a fair trade, but now a small window of opportunity, but for Method Black, the reason this composition is so strong is they have Raikou to depend on. He can trinket, he can use the darkness. That's a get out of jail free card for Chaz. Swapsy, anti-magic zone is going to be available for in a minute. Chaz getting low, Raikou runs over, and there is the darkness. So another one of those check marks found for Change My Mind for a potential win condition in this matchup.
I mean, that's a major objective, and they got it exactly when they needed to get it, right before 30 or 40% dampening. Chaz is almost out of mana, and Poike's been doing a phenomenal job so far between having Raikou chase him down, and then another Azerite trait, which you may have noticed flying through the sky from multiple members, is the Tidal Surge, which procs a Frostbolt effect from any of your damage over time effects. So the Unholy Death Knight keeps up a disease on Minpoike and then can proc that Azerite trait, and it will keep him in combat and prevent him from drinking, which then furthers Method Black's advantage with the mana rift strategy. Minpoike now totally tapped on mana at 20% dampening. This is not deep enough to kill Swapsy. Likely they will still be focusing their attention on Raikou and Chaz. Fortunately, they have forced major objectives, Chaz's Gladiator's Medallion and the Darkness of Raikou. There is currently an opening with Icy Veins and Vendetta in 14 seconds. If Acro and Fried Kitty can stabilize, remain healthy on in terms of HP, and make a swap to Chaz, they could potentially 100-0 him through Barkskin if they can catch him out of bear form. But this is a lot of things that need to go absolutely perfect for them, and once again comes down to Chaz choking.
Yeah, Icy Veins by Fried Kitty does get activated as they make a swap onto Raikou, forcing out his trinket, and Poike getting pressure down. Acro trying to deny these last few mana rifts. Anti-magic zone gets traded out as well. Method Black with a huge overlap. That was Raikou's trinket, Blur, anti-magic zone. Now there's definitely an opening here, or Change My Mind, but that was the Vendetta. Now Fried Kitty getting targeted down, then Poike with not too much mana left to work with, but Change My Mind surprisingly has really good pressure here.
Yeah, Raikou locked down. Chaz's Innervate available. He was able to heal through that setup completely for free. That was well-timed, and now Minpoike doesn't have that same luxury, at least not for another 4 seconds. Fried Kitty still on the back foot. I would say that Change My Mind have played this matchup pretty much close to perfectly at this point against Method Black, and even still, they've found the openings but can't get a kill. This composition, I don't think it's going to work for Change My Mind. Potentially, we see them bring Valet in on a larger map, something like Tolvaron Arena, for game number two. I don't want to completely count them out just yet, as Rogue Mage is always kind of a miracle composition. You can manage to pull wins out of nowhere just with miracle play and good punishes, but right now, where are the mistakes? Where are the openings? That was their Icy Beams. That was the Vendetta. They need to get a kill with this Kidney Shot. If they don't manage to, Iron Bark from Chaz appears to be enough. You can see how it's starting to overwhelm Method Black deeper into Dampening, and potentially they can ride Raikou for the rest of this. I would like to see them switch to Swapsy at a certain point, and it's going to get difficult for either side here deeper into Dampening, but Change My Mind definitely require it to be able to kill this composition from Method Black. They've got good pressure on Raikou. They've pulled Blur. They've managed to get Netherwalk, but Fried Kitty has nothing left on the back ropes, as it's a game of chicken to finish game number one off. How is Npoike going to deal with it? He's working with nothing left. He's trying to sit down for a drink while his team is at 20%. If he can get away with this and regenerate some mana, potentially he can keep them alive. He got the tiniest bit of mana to heal Fried Kitty back up, but even still being overwhelmed by the pressure.
Yeah, definitely Fried Kitty could fall here. Npoike throwing out regrowth after regrowth to keep him alive. Chaz moving in for the game-winning potential crowd control here as Fried Kitty is caught into a stun. And like you said, Sid, Change My Mind, they played that very well.
This one, I do want to potentially talk about, are there any other options that we can potentially see? That's not something that we often talk about, especially with this composition. But right now, Change My Mind is going to try to do just that. Method Black leading by one.
All right, here in game number two in the upper bracket, Change My Mind currently in third place. And they definitely want the best performance as possible so that they can solidify that to qualify to the spring finals LAN event later this year. There's a lot of teams in contention if they go down to the lower bracket. And then in the next series of the day between Wildcard Gaming and the Pumpers, I mean, it's difficult to predict who could win that, but let's just imagine for a second that Wildcard Gaming loses and goes down to the lower bracket. You're Changed My Mind, you're in the lower bracket. ABC Plot Twist, you're all within 40 points of each other, 60 points of each other to qualify. And then you've got Change Your Mind down there just knocking you around. Already Fried Kitty is falling behind here in game number two, which is going to spell devastation for Change My Mind, not only in this series, but even their potential likelihood to qualify.
Yeah, Fried Kitty had to overlap the ice block with Minpoike's Iron Bark. There seems to be a lot more pressure here for Method Black in this matchup. Chaz forced into the blind is going to trinket out of that immediately. Another little swap here over onto Raikou, but mostly Changed My Mind, they're just trying to find little windows of opportunity, and by getting Chaz's trinket, now he's a potential kill target later on. And I like what Changed My Mind did. They used the Vendetta, they baited out the anti-magic zone. Now Chaz is in a position where he doesn't have a trinket, he doesn't have the anti-magic zone, and Fried Kitty still has his icy veins. So Fried Kitty can hold on to a whole bunch of damage, he can build up icicles, as well as Fingers of Frostbrox. Potentially, they could make a big swap onto Chaz and take him down, but then you have Raikou. He has his trinket in darkness, so as long as Raikou is getting controlled, they might be able to take down Chaz, but it looks like they're not going to be going with that strategy. They're going after Raikou. They'll see what they can get done. Good crowd control onto Chaz. Raikou needing to keep himself alive, just making sure to disrupt Fried Kitty as much as possible. Beautiful interrupt, and despite the good crowd control, Raikou does manage to sustain himself and stay alive.
I mean, there's basically multiple cooldowns to cycle through for Method Black, so Chaz's Iron Bark is a defensive cooldown that he can activate on any member of the team, and it is a 45-second cooldown when talented into Stone Bark. This rotates effectively with a Demon Hunter's Blur, which in this case I believe is 35% damage reduction on a minute cooldown. Change My Mind need to try and navigate through this rotation, so basically during this moment, Chaz will use Iron Bark, or when being attacked, Bark Skin. Kidney Shot is kind of the ability that cycles between all of these on a 20-second cooldown. His team needs to respond to every Kidney Shots. Now, if someone on his team is left open and can peel or save the team, so let's say Raikou is Kidney Shots, but Swapsy is not in Polymorph, and Swapsy has a stun, he can then use his stun to stop damage, and then Method Black can avoid making a cooldown trade, extend that for later, and use it later on to try and make sure that they always have an answer. And it's basically just making sure that you always have an answer for every Kidney Shot, whether it's a cooldown or whether it's crowd control. So right now, there isn't really a good option for the stun that was engaged on Chaz. So Swapsy will make the trade here with the Anti-Magic Zone. They could have used the Iron Bark, but they went with Anti-Magic Zone because it was Akro's Vendetta. And this is a trade that Swapsy on Death Knight is making consistently. In the past, we would have seen Anti-Magic Zone traded with Icy Veins, but they don't line up perfectly. It definitely lines up better with Vendetta. And in this situation, it seems like it's enough. So this is an adaptation from Swapsy on this Death Knight. A trade that we haven't seen in the past now is being made consistently, and it appears to be more than enough.
Yeah, unfortunately, the last setup for Change My Mind, I feel like it could have been a little bit cleaner. Frag Kitty had already committed its Frozen Orb onto Raikou. Then he didn't have that for the swap over onto Chaz. Let's see, Frag Kitty now still taking quite a bit of damage as Raikou turns his attention over to him. Min Poike, what is he going to do? Activates the Innervate. Gets some free healing off for his team. It's a very important Restoration Druid ability. When you activate that ability, basically what it happens is it allows you to consistently spam out spells with no mana cost. So when your team is falling behind, you use Innervate, and that's an opportunity for you to get off some really inefficient heals that can top off your team quite quickly.
I will say Change My Mind are doing a great job in terms of maintaining their mana. They've actually got a slight lead, which would be unexpected when playing the Mana Rift strategy on the side of Method Black, and this is attributed to Change My Mind changing targets frequently. So Chaz has to constantly shift his life blooms to a new target, costing him to expend lots of mana. Fried Kitty is also timing his Polymorphs and Frost Novas, one that Swapsy is currently sitting through, so he's unable to attack. If Chaz wants to remove that, he has to use an expensive spell to dispel and remove Frost Nova and Polymorph. So I would say that Change My Mind, they're switching targets effectively. They're using Polymorph and Frost Nova to try and burn Chaz's mana down at a faster rate than Raikou can burn down Min Poike's. Right now, Raikou getting a lot of uptime. Polymorphed up, dispelled instantly, and staying on target. This is not looking too good for Min Poike. Multiple mana rifts. Raikou making sure that Imprison secures that one. Frozen Orb gets dropped to try and peel Raikou away. He just easily ducks out of that with a Fel Rush. We see a Maledict attempt here. Potential danger for Min Poike. He's responding appropriately. Barkskin, line of sighting, and avoiding the damage, but his mana isn't good enough. Min Poike has to be full mana at this point in the game if he even has a hope to get to 50% dampening. Currently sitting down for a drink in the corner. They blind Chaz to deny him from stopping Min Poike. He trinkets. Death and Decay was late. Ooh. Definitely mistakes made on the side of Method Black. Min Poike keeps his team in the game.
Yeah, Min Poike with a beautiful drink there. Method Black wasn't prepared and wasn't suspecting it, so because of that, Min Poike brings his mana from around 20% up to 60%, extending this fight. But still, compared to in a Grand Arena, Min Poike's mana is not doing great. We need to be seeing them bring this game to around 35%, 40% dampening when they can start generating pressure onto Method Black. Although Chaz has been under fire for a lot of this game, forced to use his Trinket and Iron Bark. Kidney Shot now committed as well by Akro. This is the Icy Veins. What is Chaz going to do as a response? Raikou still has his Trinket Darkness, so Method Black has that to fall back onto if they want to, but Raikou's just chasing Min Poike. He's leaving Chaz alone. Chaz could potentially fall here. Swapsy trying to back him up. A nice bash there onto Akro. That was danger time for Method Black. Raikou, with that overextension, he had to shut down Min Poike, but then he got baited to crossing the map. And that was a close call for Chaz.
If there was a game for Change My Mind to win against Method Black, it would be this one. Everything has gone in their favor, aside from maybe an early ice block, which is now basically rotated back up in 18 seconds. That was the only disadvantage they had. Chaz, in the meantime, I believe regenerated some mana. That's not too good for Change My Mind overall in this series. Min Poike unable to find that same opportunity. If we look at the objectives, it seems that Akro has opted to not even run Smoke Bomb, so maybe he wants to bring more consistent damage to the table and kill Chaz. This is the only thing that makes sense with that adaptation and talents, because the Smoke Bomb was a win condition to kill the Demon Hunter, even a win condition to kill the Death Knight later into the fight. They've only managed to make it to 13% dampening. Swapsy's still not a target. It does appear to be that Change My Mind want to kill Chaz. Maybe they can do it.
Yeah, definitely. Ray of Frost being channeled out by Fried Kitty. Chaz still trying to line of sight. Akro gets the reset. Full Garrote silence. Now onto Chaz. Beautiful bash, keeping Akro in place. And if Chaz can escape behind the pillar, ultimately he will be able to top himself off. But these consistent setups coming in from Change My Mind, it really feels like going on Chaz is the best option they have. Full blind thrown out by Akro onto Chaz. He trinkets out immediately once again. Doesn't want to have that not line up with the blind. I think it's a fair trade. It's smart. Raikou still with Darkness, Swapsy still with Anti-Magic Zone. Chaz is a little bit vulnerable with no Trinket, but still feeling quite healthy. As long as Method Black's Raikou and Swapsy are able to back him up, I think he's going to be completely fine. For Min Poike, his mana is not doing great. It's relatively even with Chaz, but just with the lacking consistent pressure Change My Mind has, he will likely be burning through that quite quickly.
If mana is even, you have a Demon Hunter who heals himself and a Death Knight who heals himself. On the opposite side, you have a Rogue who doesn't heal himself and a Mage who doesn't heal himself. Just mathematically, you can't be even on mana. You have to be so far ahead on mana if you want to be able to win this match. Minpoike picked a good map. We do see Change My Mind changing targets to Swapsy, but we're not at that critical point yet. We're not at the 40 to 50% mark, so I don't think it's likely that we see Swapsy go down, but I think switching at this point is good because they might bait him into making an overextension in terms of defensives. If they can get an Icebound Fortitude before that 35, 40% dampening mark, he's definitely a kill target for the team. So it's a matter of scaring Swapsy enough to get that cooldown right before that critical dampening moment, or potentially setting up Minpoike for a drink. But like you said, if you leave Raikou open, look what he's doing. He's just tunneling Minpoike down, mana rifting him for free. He's having a field day. Minpoike can't even escape. He really needs some backup. Fried Kitty moves over, gets a Frost Nova onto basically every opposing member of the team, including the Ghoulish Army. Really well-timed Frost Nova, good positioning by Minpoike. But now Fried Kitty is left into the battlefield. They immediately switch to him, and he's bursted down, has to ice block. Minpoike is not getting any opportunities to breathe, let alone drink.
Yep, Chaz with the renewal as well. It's a good talent for him to keep himself alive. Like you said, Minpoike completely out of mana at this point. And this is where things start snowballing out of control for Change My Mind. Minpoike into a stun, potentially last mana rift of the game, as Minpoike has nothing left to work with. What is Raikou going to do? Is he going to continue to chase down Minpoike? I think he can just turn his attention over to Fried Kitty. Second Ice Walk could potentially be forced out, or just close out the game if he's still on hypothermia.
Yep.
Looks like he is able to get it off, but Minpoike is still not having any opportunity to drink. Method Black, every single defensive cooldown at their disposal. Things are looking helpless.
The only win condition Change My Mind would have right now is killing Raikou in a smoke bomb, but Acro decided to drop that honor talent, so that's lost. I guess now their only opportunity is to kill Chaz in 10 seconds.
Ooh.
9 seconds, 8 seconds. They've got crowd control on two other members. There's no damage. The Chaz is just easily tanking this out. They now Barkskin available. Very unlikely that we see Chaz go down. And Poike totally tapped on mana. Fortunately for him, has Innervate. At least now he can make his healing free. He's going to refresh all the heal over time effects, but at 32% dampening, it also negatively affects Change My Mind. Fried Kitty is struggling. Minpoike gets gripped into the fight. He's getting cleaved down. Fried Kitty's going to fall. I will say, though, if the meta shifts into a Rogue Mage meta, Change My Mind have definitely stepped up their level in this composition.
Yeah, I think that it is fair to say we're not maybe Change My Mind, the rock star we have always wanted to see, going to try to take one map here, or they're going to be taken out by Method Black.
You know, I say Change My Mind, if the meta ever shifts, it might be advantageous to them, but in my honest opinion, they're all basically playing one class. Minpoike has a phenomenal Druid, Akra has a phenomenal Rogue, Fried Kitty, Mage, and Valet on Shadow Priest, but in terms of diversity, if the meta changes, and let's say Rogue Mage is strong, but Druids aren't, they're still in a bad position. So the best solution for Change My Mind in the long term is to start picking up more classes and some more specs. Certainly, you could say maybe it's frustrating for them they're not able to play the composition that they would like to in this current meta, but you can't always play the composition in every single meta. And whereas Method Black, they've expanded their roster. Waz is now not only known for Rogue, but he's able to play Balanced Druid, he's able to play the Warrior. We see them diversify a lot further. And then in situations like this, where Method Black used to be known as the Rogue Mage, like if you were really talking about Rogue Mage, especially in Europe, you're talking about Method Black, but now it's just Method Black. You're not even talking about them just in terms of composition. Chaz can play pretty much, I've seen every healer other than maybe Holy Priest, which is typically not seen in the tournament setting, but maybe at some point it is, and we will have to see the healers pick that up as well. But Method Black have just figured out that we need diversity if we want to win these tournaments. That's why they're so consistently making it to the top two or the top three, whereas Change My Mind are riding on an old way of thinking of just trying to make sure that their main comps, their main classes, that they're playing them out of their minds. And in this situation, it's just not enough anymore.
Yeah, I definitely would have to agree with a statement like that. Nice swap here onto Chaz, but Barkskin will be able to deny that. And just talking about the flexibility of Method Black a little bit more, this is a team where there's not really a meta I can see where they're not going to succeed. Like you said, they basically play every single composition. Chaz has every single healer at his disposal. If it's a wizard meta, then you have Raikou being able to play Mage, Swapsy being able to play the Elemental Shaman and Warlock, so you have those bases covered. And then, of course, if it's a cleave meta, you have these different compositions you can see Method Black running. And then if it just so happens that Rogue Mage is the best composition in the game, then, of course, you have Waz and Raikou being able to freestyle on teams with that. And It's nice to see, and that's really what it takes in World of Warcraft at this point to be an all-star team that's consistently having top-performing results.
Yeah, the game has just been around for a really long time now. I think we're at least a point in terms of tournament play at a decade. So these players have had a long time to pick up different classes, different specializations over time, and now at this point we see the fruits of that labor with Method Black playing basically every single style under the sun and performing like they're basically the best at every single one that they pick up. I'm curious to see how they respond if a meta shift does happen, and that's what we'll really see if their flexibility is tested, because right now they've been able to play this composition mostly exclusively with a little bit of Wizard Cleave sprinkled onto it. We haven't seen their Rogue Mage in some time. Maybe they haven't been practicing enough. Maybe that falls off and we start seeing Rogue Mage mirrors and then they're not on point, but I think that's unlikely. Method Black are still kind of a dominant force. At the same time, Wildcard Gaming, they've also diversified their roster, bringing in the Cleave setups, bringing in the Windwalker Death Knight, being able to overcome adversity through that regard. But even Wildcard Gaming are limited, because I would say they don't have any Rogue Mages. So it basically comes down to, can you play the double melee setups? Can you play the double spellcaster setups? Then can you bring in Rogue Mage or some sort of melee ranged variant composition? If you have all three of these styles with multiple options within those styles, then you've pretty much set yourself up to succeed on any potential meta. I would say that Method Black is the furthest ahead in that regard.
I have to agree with that. The one thing Wildcard Gaming does have going for them this season, at least, is it seems like they have a composition Method Black really hasn't figured out. This Demon Hunter Death Knight, the only comps we've really seen do well into it is the Windwalker Death Knight, as well as the Warrior Death Knight. So if a team can run those, I think they can definitely give Method Black a run for their money. We'll have to see if Method Black has anything prepared. A little bit different this week. Going back to this matchup specifically, Minpoike has been doing a good job sneaking away, and you can see Change My Mind. They're playing this map out beautifully. Minpoike has been able to create a lot of space. Bukambala, the biggest arena we have in the AWC, so if Minpoike can create space on this map, go for drinks, he gets a mana lead, just like we see now, and Chaz hasn't had that same luxury so far. Now another beautiful attempt over onto Raikou, and I like this. You really punish Raikou. He's the one that's most mobile, most likely to chase down Minpoike, so if you can pressure him, force him to have to sit on Fried Kitty, deny those Frostbolts, have to get onto Acro to sort of protect Chaz, then Change My Mind can set up a winning situation.
Acro setting up a swap on Chaz with no Glyer's Medallion, but once again, Swapsy makes the anti-magic zone trade with the Vendetta and basically nullifies the entire attack onto Chaz. Although right now Minpoike is doing the best he's done in any of these matches we've seen in terms of managing mana, that's important for him to get to that 40 or 50% dampening mark. The Mugombala arena choice appears to be paying off so far. We don't get to see it very often in tournament play. It's a new addition to the expansion Battle for Azeroth, so usually what happens when new arena maps come out is that the teams are reluctant to lock them in because they're not certain what is the best strategies, what compositions are actually favored on this. They don't have enough games under their belt to really feel that out. So Change My Mind kind of just doing this to see, like, maybe it works. And so far, it does. I do think that it does. They've got still a significant lead. If they can get control of Raikou and allow Minpoike to escape, we could see him sit down for more drinks. We see a swap on a Chaz. They catch him out of bear form. A bit of a disrespect by Chaz to not Barkskin. Acro getting Death Gripped away seems to be more than enough for Chaz to survive that swap. And Poike on the back foot, trying to crowd control Raikou. They've pulled his Glyer's Medallion. I still wonder if Acro is getting the most bang for his buck not running that smoke bomb talent, because now this could be an opportunity to punish Raikou for that aggressive Glyer's Medallion. Now that he knows smoke bomb isn't on the table, he can use that more aggressively to stay on Minpoike, keep nailing mana rifts, and build a lead. Obviously, Acro gains more consistency opting out of the smoke bomb, but when it comes to consistency facing this composition, I just don't think you win in that regard.
Chaz sneaking away, potentially looking for a drink. If Change My Mind can't find some pressure here, this is going to be so good for Chaz. If he can sit down, regenerate a ton of mana, then all of a sudden Method Black is in a very dominant position. Fried Kitty blinking in, using a lot of his mobility, gets stunned up by Raikou. But now Fried Kitty, he's stuck here, and Chaz was able to drink, and now they have a massive mana, not a massive, but they have a mana lead over Change My Mind. And Poike once again might have to find some windows of opportunity, and I think he may have been able to do so. He's positioned very far away right now. If Acro can land a kidney shot on Swapsy or a Frost Nova or something, maybe Minpoike can get out of combat, but it doesn't look like they're able to do it. Full Ring of Frost onto Chaz, gets reverse magic by Raikou. Good backup, and now Swapsy should get topped off quite quickly, and it's Changed My Mind that's on the back foot.
Yep, now with that drink, Chaz was able to sneak away with the map backfiring a bit. Fried Kitty has to ice block while Acro is trying to go aggressive. Things are really falling apart for Change My Mind, and they're still not at critical mass. 15% dampening is not enough. They're desperate. They're trying to go for it onto Swapsy, but not even denting him. Chaz now still actually slightly behind, even drinking. Acro gets swapped to and is stunned and bursted heavily. Multiple Gladiator's Maledicts activated, absorbing a ton of healing, forcing multiple defensive cooldowns on the side of Change My Mind. More importantly, the Iron Bark, which Benpoike would have liked to have saved for Fried Kitty. He overlapped that with personal cooldowns from Acro, and now Fried Kitty has no defense if they can connect. Benpoike is trying to deny a drink from Chaz. Will still maybe trying to drink himself. The one advantage on Mugombala is that if Benpoike jumps off this ledge downstairs, the ghoul that's chasing him will have to run all the way around on the staircase, and maybe he can drop combat while that's going on and drink. Perhaps the Z-axis could be enough for Minpoike to sneak away, but the only way I see Change My Mind in this position winning is if Minpoike gets a drink, gets full mana literally right now, while it's basically impossible for him to do it. He has to get full mana right now, while Fried Kitty somehow doesn't die while having no ice blocks, and Acro somehow doesn't die having no defensive cooldowns himself. Does that happen, Vin?
I'm not sure. We'll definitely stay tuned to find out. Acro at 50% health.
All day long. You need to stay tuned all day long right here to find out. All day. And tomorrow and the day after that, we'll see you here.
Yeah, definitely. We will be here. Chaz with the bark skin denies the kill. Another one of those cooldowns they were able to rotate through. Now 22% dampening. We've got a little bit further before Swapsy really becomes a super vulnerable target. If we can get to, like we said, 35%, 40% dampening, that's when Swapsy is going to be feeling really afraid, and Chaz is going to have to use a lot of mana to end up keeping him alive, especially with the Kleptomania talent Fried Kitty has, basically empowering his spell steal. Puts it on a 30-second cooldown, but it removes all of those heal over time effects. So when they do find crowd control like this onto Chaz, you use spell steal, every heal over time effect is gone, and that's when Swapsy's going to be really vulnerable. Beautiful shadow step kick. Now that allows Swapsy to trade out his anti-magic shell. Still has the icebound fortitude. Death strikes coming in. He gets topped off.
See, an attack like that at 40 or 50% dampening, Swapsy dies. So, but they have to make it to that point, and they just can't. There's not enough gas in the tank. There's no mana left. There's zero ice blocks, and Method Black are looking for the clean sweep as they close it out. Fried Kitty goes down. Method Black continue to assert dominance in the European region.
Oh, Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.